beautiful rainy place is not Goa. It is in the Philippines, and we are here to drive the fourth generation of the CRV that we'll get in India. This is the sixth generation globally, and it will be launched later on in October in India. So let's check out the car over the next couple of days in the hills, on the highways, in the mountains around Manila in the Philippines.
The new CRV is an evolutionary design, and there is not too much to distinguish it from the earlier generation car that was being sold in India. It is slightly more muscular, with more prominent wheel arches, has the new grille, has better ground clearance and bigger wheels, as well as a better stance, and does not look as bulky from the rear, with better proportions and a rearwards sloping roof line. The LED fog lamps and LED tail lamps all add to the contemporary look of the SUV. The interiors are where the biggest differences have been made. Now they feel plush and luxurious. Definitely a big step up towards the German machines, even though there is still a plasticky feel, the dashboard and the cabin. The CRV always was and remains a comfortable vehicle for people sitting at the back, and that has not changed with the addition of third row of seats. The second row offers as much flexibility as before. The panoramic sunroof, the lane view camera, attention assist and lane keeping assist are new features added to the car to bring it at par with the premium offerings in this segment.
Engine feels a little underpowered. It is not ideal for this car, but for fuel efficiency and for city driving, it may just be par for the course. What I like about the CRV on the inside are the new instrument panel, the infotainment system is good as well, and for the first time we'll have a car in India which is equipped with a lot of driver assistance aids, starting with the camera on the right for traffic warning. So of course I'm hoping the camera will be on the left in India, and there is also lane keeping assist. There's also all the systems that you can use with the radar and a camera combined, so adaptive cruise control works on this car as well. The instrument panel also gives out a huge amount of information. You can switch to various displays, including a four-wheel drive torque distribution display, which tells you that the car is now actually on four-wheel drive, but the front wheels are getting more torque than the rear wheels. Even though the ground clearance on this car has been increased from the previous generation, in fact it is even higher than the first generation car, but the body roll is not too much. It still feels more like a car than a bulky SUV. It drives more like a car. After having driven the four-wheel drive, or rather the all-wheel drive CRV yesterday, we've switched to the two-wheel drive one. Yeah, both with the 1.6 diesel power plants. And we've just driven up Mount Samad, where behind me is one of the national monuments of the Philippines. It was a beautiful drive coming up, but now let's get back into the car and drive some more to check out what the front-wheel drive CRV feels like.
The The front wheel drive car definitely feels lighter to drive around than the AWD, and indications on our drive were that it will be substantially more fuel efficient as well. Many of the features like the sunroof and the driving assistant features are missing on this lower trim car, but of course it will be priced much lower as well.
So we have been driving the Honda CR-V, the 6th generation car globally, and the 4th generation car that will be coming to India over the last 2 days around the Philippines. We started off in Manila, the capital city, and across the main island on the main expressway that cuts across this island and into the hills, and now we are at the beach side. First I drove the 4-wheel drive car, and now I'm driving the 2-wheel drive car, and I have to say it's a big improvement over the old CR-V. Although the plastics are still there on the interiors, but the interiors are much more luxurious. The infotainment system is all new, and the instrument panel as well, with a lot of information. The third row of seats adds to its appeal, but the only problem will be the 1.6-litre diesel engine, which is a little sluggish and not conducive for spirited driving. But overall, the car is a huge improvement, and we are just waiting to see what Honda prices the car at when it launches it in October.